pockets of resistance all around the planet. We've been fighting a long time. You're listening to this. You are not alone. You are the resistance.
This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back. You take the blue pill. The story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill. You stay in Wonderland. And I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes. Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
So what's up, family? What's going on? So, man, a couple things I want to talk to y'all about today, man. Some things that probably not gonna be able to put much up on here on YouTube. I'm gonna probably kind of brush over just a tad bit because, like I said, man, I can't really talk about some things on here. That's become more apparent as I did pick up two strikes in the last month. So, like a lot of the videos, a lot of the content. A lot of content that I normally put out, man, I'm not gonna be able to put it out like that on this YouTube. Like, I be wanting to get on this channel, man, because this is like one of my biggest audiences that I have. Alright, so I want to get on here and be able to reach people, and that's one of the things that kind of came to my attention. Obviously, we weren't on this channel in the last 2 weeks, so somebody brought to my attention that we had the 25% discount that we were doing in the detox shop over the last, from Halloween. It went from Halloween to like November 4th. I might have extended to the 5th, man, because there was some people that tried to jump in last minute, but apparently like everybody that's just on this channel did not get that information. So a lot of people didn't get the benefits of that discount. So what we gonna do, man, I decided I would come back and do a discount for the rest of this week. For those that do see this video, we will go back and do the 25% off on the detox shop stretch from here, which is the 13th. We're gonna say the 13th to the 18th. 13th to 18th. So 5 days, man. 5 days to get a 25% off discount with the discount code Get Back. Okay, so basically getting back the savings that you missed. All right. So anybody that's looking to get one of the detox packages, man, the bundles or something like that, man, 25% off. That's a great savings. It's gonna save you quite a bit. So if you're getting a $200 bundle, it'd be like $150, which is pretty decent, right? So you can get the internal, external cleanse, as well as start decalcifying your pineal gland and everything like that, as I have done, as you can see, man. And for those of y'all that take care of your skin and stuff like that, obviously you see my skin, man, is pretty clean. I've been using the New Dawn, which like I said, the New Dawn, man, that specifically targets the parasites, all right, also the toxins and impurities that's in your pores in your skin, which people don't know nothing about. The thing about that, we talk about internal detox over the course of your lifetime, but how many have actually cleansed your face, your skin? Okay, we're talking about the body shot. You do the body shot, you get the stuff off your skin as far as the stuff they putting in the skies, all right, also technology and stuff that we can't really talk about. I ain't gonna talk about it. Y'all know what I'm talking about if you've been following me. But with the New Dawn, man, if you don't know, and I might put a piece in here, I don't know, man, but the New Dawn basically deals with the parasites in your face, man, in your skin. Like when you was younger, you might have acne and stuff like that, man. A lot of that stuff is just related to, you know, parasitic infections in the face and whatnot. So thing with parasites in the face, they tend to eat on like oil and stuff in the skin. So if you got oil in your skin and stuff, they tend to eat on that and they feed on that until they die. They only have a short lifespan, but they continue to regenerate, repopulate on your face. I know it sounds terrible, right? But what they do is, man, they eat over a course of time, then they come on the surface of your skin at night, and then they breed. So they mate with other parasites on your face, and then they go back into your pores and they lay eggs. All right, you can look this up, man. It's, like I tell you, I'll be bringing y'all stuff because I've been studying this stuff for quite some time. So that's why we got the detox shop. So So the whole thing, guys, with the parasites that are on your face, that live in your face, basically, they don't have like an anus, whatever, right? So they don't never take a crap. Well, I take that back. They kind of do, but it's only when they die. So when they die, they basically die in your face. So all the stuff they've been eating and everything over the course of their lifetime is still in their bodies, and that's why they die after a certain amount of time. They don't live long. I think the lifespan for parasites in the face is like 2 weeks, something like that. So after they consumed all that oil and stuff in your skin on your face and stuff over the course of their lifetime, then they go inside your face and then they die, and the toxic waste that they have in them goes all in your face. It's pretty disgusting. So it's the same thing, man, like when they in your system. So when you got, you know, like you got parasites in your system, man, they moving throughout your body, but they consuming things, they eating things, and then they're leaving waste in your system. They're leaving waste, toxic waste in your body.
What if I told you that right now you have dozens of tiny mites eating, laying eggs, dying, and leaking feces all over your face? Turns out, you probably do. I'm Anna Rothschild, and this is Gross Science. Face mites, or Demodex mites, are wormy-looking creatures with 8 tiny legs. They're arachnids, related to spiders, scorpions, and ticks, and they're really common. They're found in pretty much every society on the planet, and most healthy adults have at least a few. People usually acquire their first mites during childhood, but they don't really start getting busy till you hit puberty. And that's because face mites love oily skin. They live in the hair follicles on your forehead, cheek, and nose, or, depending on the species, inside the sebaceous, or oil-producing glands surrounding those follicles. They eat sebum, or skin oil, and also slurp out the insides of your dead skin cells. And that's where things get really gross. You see, face mites don't have anuses.
Bummer.
They store all of their poop in their abdomens until the day they die, at which point they decompose and leak feces all over your face. In fact, some scientists think that the bacteria in their poop could be related to certain skin conditions, like rosacea or blepharitis. Each mite only lives for about 2.5 weeks, but that's more than enough time for them to crawl out onto your skin at night, to mate around the edges of your hair follicles. The female then burrows back down and lays one gigantic egg. 2.5 days later, you've got a brand new baby mite, ready to once again begin the circle of life on your face. Ew.
Okay, any type of toxic waste, man. I'm talking about, you talk about horse deposits, you talk about human deposits, feces and stuff, man. You're not supposed to have that stuff in your system, on your system. You're not supposed to consume that stuff. But it tends to happen because of stuff like this, all right? And I had a piece, man, and I'm gonna play it in the video that's on Rumble, where the guy was talking about how the whole thing with him and his cancer situation, and it all relates to that. But we already talked about that stuff, man, but it goes back to the parasitical thing, right? So either way, man, just wanted to point that out. Basically, with the new dime, man, it starts to dry out that oil that they eat, and also it attaches itself to them. Okay, because it's got the activated charcoal, as well as the bentonite and green clay. It's a mix, but it's a good combination, man, that targets those things. So either way, man, you see with me, skin's still looking pretty fresh and young, youthful. You know, I found a fountain youth, but my beard, as you can see, has gone gray. It's going gray. Some of y'all been around for a long time, man. Y'all seen me when I just had a black beard, or I didn't have a beard at all. But now here I am, you know, with gray coming in. So they say it's wisdom. That's what they always say. Like, when you get gray, you get wisdom. As you see, I'm not aging like in my face so much, but obviously my hair is starting to go gray. Just my beard though, it's weird. I'm gonna be looking like Moses or something in a minute, man, right? But anywho, man, the video, that I got going here is basically gonna just touch on some stuff, man, as far as connections and things, man, from a spiritual aspect. We're gonna be talking about that. But the piece that I can't put in here, that I wanted to put in here, was the guy was talking about the technology and stuff, and how far back it goes, as far as how far back they've been targeting us with this specific technology that they've been using. Like, a lot of people don't know about it. They assume, like I tell y'all all the time, you might just get wind of something today, but it's been going on for some time now. So you have to look at that, man, and establish, like we've been talking about. And I'm gonna get into the video, because I just kind of put this on front because I want people to tell people about the discounts that we was gonna go for the detox shop for the people that missed it. But it really just goes in, man, about how it's other things that they've implemented to make sure they got this technology going, man. So I'm gonna play it, but I'm gonna cut it. I'm probably not gonna play his piece in here, because it's risky, and I believe it'll get flagged, man. Like I told y'all, I'm getting manual reviews and stuff, so I gotta float under the radar. I apologize, man. You know, I know a lot of people be like, man, Net, won't you, you know, why you stay on YouTube? Like, people come on YouTube, man, they like, man, we missed you. We missed you, Net. I'm like, man, hey, I miss you guys too. I wish I could be on here and talk to you like I used to. I wish it was like old times. But we in a new day and age, man. So I tell you, you gotta be new, you gotta be innovative in how you approach this. Like, I gotta be discreet on how I bring the information to y'all. Right? It's like when you disclosing stuff to people out in the street, you gotta be discreet about how you present the information, or you'll run them off. You know what I mean? Like, you can't come out all strong and aggressive. Like, I think we all experienced that, man. Like, early on, I think everybody kind of got to that point where they was like angry, mad, like trying to get their point across, because you probably went through so much persecution, whether it be on your job or amongst your family members and peers, man. The people, you know, downplaying what you was talking about and labeling you a conspiracy theorist or whatnot. I think we all experienced that. And outcast from your family, can't go to different events, all that crap, man, that we all went through during the experience or the experiment, right? And I think at some point we all got frustrated. I know I did. You know, I know I had subs hit me up. You know, they was frustrated asking me, like, what's the best way to deal with these folks. And like, as we started to learn, man, it wasn't so much about talking to people, just talking to them, because it was bigger than that. Like, it's stuff that was going on, you know what I mean? Like, mentally, you know, we start talking about the parasitic aspect. We start talking about the technology. We start talking about the stuff that they've been implementing, right? We started talking about that, and then we started to get a better understanding of why they put these different things out to, you know, monitor, not only monitor, but control, you know, and hook people up to the hive mind. That's why I tell y'all, man, for those that ain't, like, if you kind of, like, in between, or if you even had thoughts about taking your butt down and taking a walk, man, then it very well is because of the control mechanisms that they put in you, okay? Those ain't your thoughts. Like I tell y'all, man, they have control over different organisms and things that they put in people, so they can send thoughts and stuff to your mind. Not only that, but the technologies. And I did a whole piece on it, man. Some people are like, man, this dude talking crazy. I did a whole piece on it where I brought out like two or three different guys, man, that explained that they work for these companies, and they targeted cities, whole populations of people with mind control, putting voices in their head, telling them what to do. Telling them what to do, and they would follow them orders. So I'm just bringing y'all the information. You might not like the message that I'm bringing, but you can't dismiss the message that I'm bringing, because there's credible sources behind it. They're saying, yeah, like, this is what we did. This is what we do. You know, and a lot of y'all, man, like, a lot of us, like the dude said, and if you watch this video, man, you might get to the point where I have to cut it, because you can't see that information. That, like, even when they were broadcasting it, when they were recording it, they were tampering with the broadcast so that information couldn't get out. So, like I say, it's bigger than me, man, and the stuff I be telling y'all. I give y'all information that you're not supposed to have. A lot of information that I find and I research and I run into it, they blocked it already, to where I can't even pull it so I can redistribute it. You see what I mean? Like, the information, I find myself in so many dead ends, you know, trying to get the information. That's how you know, but I know that I'm on the right path, you know, on the route to truth, because the information is always going to be filtered. You know what I'm saying? Like with me, like somebody pointed out the other day on my video, like, damn, how the net got this many thousands of subscribers, but they only let 15, 20 people know that he's going live. Let this many people, you know. But I told y'all that before, man. There's no way, you know, that, like, for me, like, if I do a new, I could start a new channel today or tomorrow. And I guarantee you it's going to start flying. And then next thing you know, like, one day it's just going to stop. It's going to come to a dead halt and it's not going to move. That's all my, I don't care what platform it's been on, whether it's BitChute, it's been Rumble, it's been YouTube. It grows at an exponential rate and then it just halts. It just halts. And y'all know the stuff I went through early on. People, they were snatching likes, they were snatching videos, they were snatching subscribers, they was turning off people's notifications. Like, they literally went into my subs and was like we gonna start shutting all this down. Like, this stuff, we don't need. Because the problem was, man, and I told y'all at one point, like, I could go in my analytics and could see it. My videos were being shared over 200,000 times a month. That is insane. 200,000 times a month shared. That's how you get 1,500 subscribers a day. You see what I'm saying? So yeah. Either way, man, I ain't about to harp on that, but I want y'all to kind of know that's what I run. So, like, a lot of the videos and stuff I have for y'all, they got removed. They were private. Like, I had a private playlist and stuff that I was putting together, all that, and they just removed it. So all the videos that I used, luckily me, I saved all these videos, all this information, which I always did, and been able to bring, you know, bring that stuff back out here and there. But for the most part, all them other truthers, all the videos and information that was put on the net over that time, a lot of that stuff got removed. So obviously I can't use some of that stuff no more. But the point of the matter, like I was saying, man, the guy that I'm gonna talk about in this video, so you'll get to see. But even with him, man, like, this video is dated like 2015. So it's before we even stumbled across the information about it potentially being, you know, some kind of technology being used. They was already onto it. That's why I told y'all, just because we found out today, like, oh my God, they putting stuff in the chicken. This, and nah, they've been doing that. So they've been putting it. And if you got to think about it, guys, so I told y'all what I went and did, I went and took a magnet and I stuck it to my chest. I was like, what the hell? Because I was like, yo, I ain't take no walk, right? But when I did, I was like, oh crap. That's when I started doing the detox stuff, man. Started using the Genesis and stuff like that, stuff that they advocated for that would remove the stuff out your system, all right? So that you wouldn't be, like, either monitored or either controlled or either messing with your health. You see what I'm saying? It's either monitored, controlled, or messing with your health. One or the other. But, like I said, we were thinking, oh, they just doing this and that and other. Now, granted, that technology, we don't know exactly what it does, but I think this guy breaks it down to some degree. Like I said, I can't play it on here. But that was just one of the things that they were implementing. When they started going straight to the brain, man, that's a whole different story. It's a whole different ballgame, because we can't even say that they're using the technology the same way in every aspect. You understand what I mean? Like, they could be using it, you know, getting it on you so they can monitor your vitals and things and your behaviors and stuff, the stuff that you're doing. But then again, they could also be putting stuff straight to the brain so they can control, you know, your thoughts and your mind and your emotions and everything like that. Then they could be also putting them in, make sure they go to another different set going in your body to make sure that they mess with your health. You know what I'm saying? Then you got the other things that we talk about. I ain't gonna say it on here, but them things go in and they cause all kind of problems, man. And I'm not even gonna say what, but they cause all kind of problems. All right, and they are making sure that these things get in you, whether it was Pop Quiz, whether it was the mask. You understand what I'm saying? So y'all gotta look at that, man, and understand that, hey, I keep telling y'all all the time, man. That's why sometimes I come out here and I'm in my army fatigues. We are in a freaking war zone. At the end of the day, this is a war zone, man. You getting hit and blanketed with crap every day. Every day. And it's simple once you know, okay, this is what they doing. Okay, this is what I need to do to stop that. Bam. You know what I'm saying? But if you don't know, then you either on course to, you know, have some serious health problems or DEPOP. It's that simple. You know, and some people take heed and they do stuff and they avoid it. Their life might last a little longer. But ultimately, man, this is an ongoing thing. Every time you step outside, you're being exposed to the elements and the different stuff that they doing. Even drinking water and stuff, man, the stuff they putting in the water. You got to be on your P's and Q's. You know what I'm saying? So, anywho, man, I just wanted to put this at the beginning of the video. Like I said, we're going to do the 25% for the rest of the week to the 18th, man, the get back. Coldest big get back. I might put that on the screen so y'all see it, man. So if you didn't get to get the discounts from the Halloween, the healthy Halloween, we are gonna run that back, man, just for the 5 days, like I said, for the folks that missed it due to it, the strikes that was on this channel not being able to get that information out to you guys. So I apologize for that, man, and hopefully you can benefit from us running this special back. So y'all enjoy the rest of the video.
Battery packs in the human body. On one side, it's how many electrons are we putting in? And there are a lot of electron donors. Electron donors can be getting out in the sun, can be walking barefoot in the grass, it can be leaning up your body up against a tree, because the tree has electrons and will donate them to you. Hugging an animal, a common way that makes people in nursing homes feel better is to buy them a dog or a cat. They hold the dog or the cat and get electrons from it. The animal runs outside and recharges itself and brings some back to you. Moving water in is an electron donor, whereas still water tends to be an electron stealer. Moving air is an electron stealer. That's why when you ride in a convertible, you look really cool, but you're always tired when you get there because the wind is that steals electrons from you. On one hand, we look at what things can put electrons in the body and then what things steal them. And again, the most common stealers are dental infections, emotional baggage, various toxins, particularly the toxins that we are getting from things like GMO foods and pesticides and other kinds of things, air pollution. There's a lot of toxins around us. And of course, one can almost include in the concept emotional baggage. They're toxins in a different way in that they rob us of voltage that we should be using for something else.
Hey, what's up, family? What is going on? So, man, haven't talked to you guys in a little minute, man. I think I slipped on a couple days, so I was gonna try to stay a little more consistent with what I was doing. But a couple things I wanted to hit on real quick, man. first off, I did get access to my main channel. I got access to my main channel back, so I'm gonna drop. I don't know. I haven't decided how I'm gonna really navigate it because I'm floating on thin ice, man. I am. So I gotta try and try to be a little more discreet about how I'm delivering the information. So I don't know. I don't know how much I can put on there, man. Cause like I said, man, I actually get manual reviews. Like that's when you know you got. You got some folks on you. When you get manual reviews, like they tell me, you know, like after they ban something, they say, yeah, we did a review on your channel, and after doing a manual review, it was then decided that we would take it down. Like, so they do the auto. Like I told y'all, I always get the autos. Okay, so when my videos get uploaded, they go through a process, and then a lot of times they'll drop it right then. You know, they'll drop it right then. And then, you know, that's because they got the bots, the AI system, man, which is so intricate how they use that AI system, man. I'm trying to tell y'all, you don't know about AI technology yet, man. I'm telling you, that stuff is real. Like, they don't even have to look. They look for keywords, just like you screen for keywords when you go to Google. They got a system that screens the videos for keywords, okay? And from what I'm hearing now, they got something that searches for certain images and things like that. It's crazy. So, either way, I try to be discreet, man. And, I don't know, because this video I'm making now, I think it's just going to go on Rumble. I might come back and hit y'all with something on YouTube. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that, but as far as right now, guys, like I said, I get the manual reviews, so they'll go in and they'll have somebody personally sit and watch my video and then decide if it's gonna go up. And you already know they got it out for me, so of course they're gonna say like, no, we're not gonna put it up, we're gonna ban it. Like, manual reviews, man, is tricky. So I'm really gonna probably steer clear of getting too deep with stuff on my main channel. Some of y'all know, man, some of y'all understand, you know, like I said, some people don't understand why I do things the way I do. Normally what I've done in the past, in the case I got up to certain amount of strikes, I just removed the content, you know, off the channel. But they did let me know, they went through all my videos and stuff, and so far that's what they came up with. That last video that I put out, Crucial Catch, and then it was one right behind that. I think it was Forbidden Facts. Might have been. Yeah, I think that was it. But they decided they wasn't gonna let them videos ride, man. So certain things we can't talk about. But since we're here on Rumble, man, I wanted to go ahead and hit on some stuff, man. Y'all just follow me that's over here from Rumble, y'all already know what it is, man. We don't have to sugarcoat. We don't have to hold our breath or hold our tongue, rather, when we talking about certain things. And y'all know a key topic that we've been on, man, is obviously the cleansing of your system. I keep on reiterating to you guys how important that is, because that is the gist of how they operate. Okay, everything right now is about putting stuff in your system and DEPOP. Okay, depopulation. That's all this stuff is about. All right, some folks, man, is wondering why they getting sick, why they having some of the ailments that they having, like can't get healthy, they constantly remain sick, stuff constantly happening to them, man. It's because of what is in your system. It is that simple, man. It is that simple. And the reason I brought that up, man, is because, like, I stumbled across this information, another sub hit me off with it, so I'm going to play it. But there's a guy here, his name is Tony, and he's kind of hitting on the whole technology aspect, how it's been incorporated, what it's doing in your system, what it's doing, why you feel certain ways, certain stuff that's going on, how long this technology's been implemented, what it's been doing to people. Okay, like we've been hitting on it, and on top of that, guys, it's like I tell you all the time, just because we find out something today doesn't mean it wasn't going on yesterday. Okay, these processes, man, been going on for quite some time. All right, we just smart enough to find out about it when we did. A lot of folks already knew about this stuff. Like, I didn't know about this stuff. There's a lot of people knew about this stuff before me. All right, and it goes back to the piece. I'm going to put a video, guys. I'm going to put a video up on Rumble that's going to really iron out every aspect of the technology, the microfibers that they spraying through the parasites that they've been putting in, and the smart dust. Okay, all of that stuff is going to be ironed out so that you can show this to your family member, friends, loved ones, so they can start getting a better understanding. Like, you got to watch all of that information and see what they doing, what's going on. All right, but to put stuff in perspective, man, this guy, he breaks it down pretty thorough. I'm going to play some of it. It's a long video, so I ain't going to play it all. I'm going to play a little piece of it, man, so you can kind of see. The stuff been going on since, like, the 40s. Okay, this is what they've been doing.
So, for a lot of people requesting Mr. Tony Pantelaresco, thank you for being on the show today.
Thanks for having me.
So glad.
Right now, our weather is what your weather is because of the geoengineering of the weather. I live in Windsor, Ontario, and if you were to draw a line across the United States and Canada, I'd be right where Northern California and Oregon meet. And so we're in the hottest spot of Canada and sunniest spot, actually. And so right now the weather, because I deal with a lot of people from California with health issues. It seems to be the four major spots I deal with are California, Texas, Florida, New York, and then the Midwest like Utah and Iowa.
Uh-huh.
So again, we're always comparing weather, and there's been no change. Our weather's been geoengineered, and so we've had your weather and our weather has been about the same. Huh. So it's been probably damp and cool there where you are as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Today we're supposed to go into a different change, snow, sleet, and whatnot. But Here, the winters are milder by comparison to, say, Calgary, Alberta, where you can get down to minus 50 on the Celsius scale, which is like minus 60 on the Fahrenheit scale. So there it can be a bit brutal.
Isn't there a weather modification system that thing? Isn't there something up there near Canada?
We got seven of them in Canada. Oh.
Seven of them in Canada.
Yeah, we got seven of them in Canada. I found this out on this administration for the election. Our prime minister challenged the Russians on a territorial claim. And I kept thinking to myself, how in the heck are we challenging the Russians? All we have is two tugboats and a canoe for a navy. Then, Canada is a military country, a militaristic country, just not a... It's not well publicized. And anyway, I found out about 2 or 3 days after he made that issuance there that we had seven installations, which basically if you target another country's weather, you can pretty well cripple them. So it's probably the next technology. And these are technologies that are so extremely dangerous and alarmingly dangerous. A lot of people aren't fully grasping the scope of when you see that line in the sky. How it can drop a particle agent or a nano agent, and you get afflicted with these things. How it can alter the climate. How it can alter the agricultural chemistry that's required for certain heat or chemicals in the soil to react. Aquatic life, bird life, things of this nature.
Tony, what do you mean by the line in the sky? You're talking about trails? Is that what you mean?
Yeah, okay. Because a lot of people. I mean, there are still some people today that are. Still with this concept that all this is a jet exhaust, and there's been actually U.S. government sites, NASA sites in the last few weeks.
This is why, guys, and like I just said, we find out stuff today, but it was already going on. People start finding stuff, like I said, in the chicken, in certain meats and stuff. And it's not just the chicken. It's the water. It's all kind of stuff that they've been using, man. It's even in the fruit. They've been putting this technology out there, man, getting this stuff into your system. This is why people be sick as much as they do. You ever notice, like, people just sick, man. And then they just, like, people that took the walk. Yeah, you got the shed stuff going on, you got the shedding aspect, but outside of that, even before, just coming up sick is not something that would normally happen because you do have a strong immune system. But when you got people that are evil folks that's up here working overtime to make sure that you're not healthy, to make sure that you have some kind of long-lasting sickness or disease, then you're gonna have that. If they're investing all of their billions of dollars that you pay your tax money into, they investing that into making sure you get sick, guess what? You're gonna be so. Anywho, man, it's really about just unveiling this stuff, man, and putting it out there so people can kind of see. But the thing is that we have to look at as well, man. We talk about and everything, but what we don't realize is that they already have been doing that. Who's to say that 3G, 4G towers wasn't already doing something? You see what I'm saying? Like people talking about 5G because came out now, that's to utilize some of these other things that they put out with the walk. But prior to that, they already had towers. The stuff that they beat that you normally use is never really for our good, and we never gonna know the truth of what's really happening because they don't tell us that. They just put stuff out there, they run tests on you, and when they get caught, that's when they say, oh, they were just running some little test, or they was just trying something out. No, they wasn't. This is an ongoing program that y'all already running. This ain't no, we just tested something out right now. That's the BS line that they give so that they can get away with it. Like, oh, it was a mistake. Oh, we stopped it. Oh, it's cool. Y'all go back to sleep type thing. You know what I mean? So either way, man, it's important that people know, man, because at the end of the day, like I tell y'all all the time, man, we're not supposed to die in our 70s. We're not supposed to die in our 60s, our 50s, our 40s. Do you understand now that people are dying in their 40s of what they're deeming as natural causes? I tell y'all this all the time, man. Natural causes. People are dying in their 40s in their sleep of natural causes. people are dropping dead of heart attacks, and they saying natural causes. And you know what? If you keep on repeating that, when people die, guess what? By the time our kids get to be about our ages, guess what they're going to think when somebody died at 27? Oh, he died of natural causes. Natural causes. Well, how did he die? He was just walking down the street and, you know, he just fell out. This is natural causes. What? That don't even make sense, but to them, it'll make sense. Just like today, we accept the deaths of cancer. We accept the deaths of AIDS. We accept these things because we've been programmed to accept it. Like I tell y'all, man, when you're born into this world, man, you come in and, like I tell y'all, you came from somewhere, okay? You were introduced into a body, into a vessel, all right? With you comes everything that you are, your whole essence of your spirit, which the spirit and the soul becomes one. It's one in itself. So the spirit is like the mind of the soul. It's like the body and the brain. It's like one. It's like connected, right? But when you come here, you have all these memories, all this stuff from the past, all this stuff that you embody from past lifetimes and whatnot. If you've had a past lifetime, you may not. I don't know. This could be your first lifetime. All right, your first run through this stuff could be, you know, right now. And then in the future, you will have future lifetimes. Okay, depending on where you go when you talk about going through dimensions or whatnot. But either way, man, when you come here, it's like you go through the process of brain wiping or sweeping, to where as they remove all of your thoughts and everything else. So you think about that because it's like, well, if I come here as a soul, right, being shot into a body, I don't have a brain. Your soul doesn't have a brain. You see what I'm saying? Like, where's the thoughts and everything come from? If the brain is supposed to be where all the thoughts are stored, then where do the thoughts come from if you come as a soul and you bring in past experiences? Like I told y'all, man, and this before I ever heard anything from Dr. Deborah Blair. He was talking about babies born between 67 and 89, I think he said. And some of y'all might have been born in this time period too. But babies born in that time period were likely lost in wars. In wars, guys, he said that. Y'all know how long I've been telling y'all since, like, man, since the beginning. I told y'all, man, like, I had the reoccurring dreams as a 5 and 6 year old that I was dying in a war. I always told y'all that stuff, man. So to hear him say that, man, it just only, you know, only validated, you know, everything that I had already kind of been stumbling across just from being connected now, you know what I'm saying, to where I'm like, man, so some things start to make sense. And it talked about how we would be advanced souls, okay, which may be why I'm who I am, what I do, you know, who knows what my journey or my path is supposed to be. I don't know. I'm still trying to figure this stuff all the way out, but, you know, I don't know. And some of y'all might feel the same way. I always just had that feeling, like that thought, that I was very different. And I told y'all this before. I always felt like the folks around me wasn't real people. And, you know, like maybe I'm just really in some kind of system, you know, and it's really about me and what I do in this system. I really felt like that. I don't know. But some of y'all might have felt the same way, which may be why, you know, we weren't easily controlled when the stuff went down the way it did. You know, we got our own mind and our own way of thinking and putting together information. But I said that to say this, man. You come here and you have these thoughts, these memories and stuff that you can't identify with. And as soon as you get here, they start the wiping, the sweeping of the mind. They start the process, right? They start doing that. And by the time you at school age, you've already been wiped clean. And then they start the you know, the uploads of bullshit, basically. Start uploading all the information into your mind that they want you to believe. They want you to be indoctrinated. They want you to, you know, be under their authority and not question stuff. It's like, I said, just like They Live, Roddy Piper was saying, they get you to that point where you don't have any thoughts of your own. You don't think outside the box.
You know, sometimes I look around and I just wonder, what's gonna happen to all these people? All these lost souls who believe what they see on the news, believe voting can change a system, believe we're going to Mars. We are on the verge of the biggest transformation in human history, and all these people care about is, are you voting for Trump or Hillary? Who won the game on Sunday? Or did you buy an iPhone 7? It's truly unbelievable. Could you imagine if the power grid went out? People cannot live without their phones for 5 minutes. What if the power went out for 5 months? These people are lied to every single day of their lives. They are living the biggest lie they can possibly imagine. They are not going to know what hit them when this world crumbles. And it will. They will wake up all right, but it'll be too late. I'm sure many of you feel the same, but sometimes I wish I never thought for myself. Sometimes I wish I never looked into things, questioned the system, questioned reality, because it's just so overwhelming sometimes. This world is so sick. Everything is backwards, rigged, corrupt, fake. Beyond comprehension. We live in such a synthetic reality. Everything about this world is fake. Fake food, fake political system, fake religious system, fake medical system, fake money, fake skies. It's unreal. You know what I think? I think in this absolute fake rigged reality in which we live, you want to know what the only real thing is? The only thing that matters, that's real? It's your spirit, your soul, the spiritual, because they can't take that from you. That you can save, because you can't change the system. This sick, fake world was meant to fall, and there's no other way around it. You think we're dealing with mere humans? These psychopaths in control are vessels. They're all influenced by forces beyond this realm, beyond your perception, beyond this physical dimension that you perceive. This is why the world is the way it is. This is how they are able to carry out their sick agenda against us all and do the things they are capable of doing. Because understand, this goes beyond the flesh. This is why there is a new world order. After many years on this journey of finding some type of truth in this world, This is what I finally realized. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. This is what we are dealing with. This is why the world is the way it is. The way I see it, the sooner you understand this simple truth, the better off you'll be. God bless.
Heaven and hell are not places, they are mind states. Heel is hell, the root chakra. Head is heaven, earth rearranged is heart. The three parts of the brain control the three sections of the body. Depending on which brain is dominant, you are either manifesting heaven or hell. If you're thinking with your gut area all the time, you are manifesting hell. The devil has goat features, which is a ground animal. The angel has wings, which is an air animal. The angel is your higher self, the devil is the lower self. Hence why the devil is red, because red is the lowest vibrational color. The devil is the de-veiling, because you are mental, astral, etheric, and physical. You are de-veiling yourself by sitting in the lower states of consciousness. The body does not live, it is only maintained by the consciousness that is within it. And this consciousness is either operating in hell or heaven, depending on the three brains that you use dominantly. You descended from spirit into matter. Now you need to go back up to your true spirit form and move up the stairway to heaven, which is your spine. They've externalized it and turned it into a religion to hide the true power of yourself. The square symbolizes the physical plane, the triangle is the etheric plane, and the circle is the eternal plane. You need to think outside the box. The box is the cross unfolded, the cube, the physical world. The Christians believe 144,000 will go to heaven. This is actually a frequency you need to achieve to go from the root to the crown chakra, because your head is heaven and your heel is hell. The link is in the bio for the Book of Wisdom PDF.
They teach you what to think, not how to think. And then they put you in that system to where it's like, think about it. How much time do you spend actually developing your spiritual side? How much time is devoted to that? If that's truly who we are, then don't you think you should put a lot of time into that? But that's so far off from what you're doing. And that's why I tell you too, man, even when you talk about from a biblical aspect, it don't so much push spirituality. Notice how the religion and spirituality is listed as separate. You talk about when people say, well, what are you? Are you religious? Are you Christian? Are you spiritual? You know, it's just like boom, boom, boom. Like you can't, it's like you almost can't be both. But actually, in actuality, there is a connection between, right, spirituality and religion, okay? And if they tie in both, they can also confuse you in how you perceive things and how you interpret the messages and information. You can interpret on a physical level and miss the whole spiritual meaning. You can. And a lot of people do that on a regular basis. Even when you go through things in life, we tend to accept what we see on the physical opposed to what's really happening, what it means on the spiritual. You know what I mean? Like, find myself trying to use instances that I don't want to use because I don't want to put too much out there, but let's say this. Like I told y'all the last video where I was talking about energy, code of energy, that video, I was talking about how you know, things happen to you in a physical world that keep you from being harmed, that keep you from being sent back off, you know, into the spiritual realm, okay? But you just saw it as a physical episode, something that happened in the physical that just was a freak occurrence, but actually there was some spiritual implications behind it that kept you in positions so that you wouldn't be caught up in a situation that would send you on your way, if you know what I mean. Even like for some people, man, you might have people in your lifetime, man, that you come across and you might not think nothing of it coming across these certain people, but it could be because like I said, you could come across certain people, man, because there's some spiritual implications behind it. Okay, whether that be because y'all are interrelated spiritually, whether y'all are supposed to have a lifetime together, you know what I'm saying? Like, people always say, oh, well, I'll see you next lifetime. Well, maybe next lifetime, right? Well, true story is maybe it is for you to be with that person or know that person next lifetime or have some kind of relationship with that person in that next lifetime. Or maybe you already have and you just don't know it. See, that information ain't gonna just come to you. But if you had, you know, full access to your pineal and they didn't disrupt it with all this damn chemicals that they making sure they put in, maybe you would recall and maybe you'd be able to connect spiritually and know. Because you gotta think, man, I'll be telling y'all, you see people here, you see people by their face, you identify by faces. You know what I'm saying? You identify by faces. You communicate through communication, through your mouth, okay, talking, body language, okay, verbal language cues and stuff, verbal cues and whatnot. These are the ways that you communicate as a physical being. But if you took this physical appearance away, if everything just dropped off, I'm talking about everything from the sky, the ground, the trees, the skin on everybody, how would you identify with somebody? How would you know your mom was your mom? If you couldn't see her face and you couldn't hear her voice, how would you know that she's who she is? But you understand that we spiritual beings first. So how would you have any relationship with anybody if you're not able to communicate or not able to see them? And it's like I said, this goes back to the perspective I gave y'all as far as Adam and Eve, okay, how they was in the Garden of Eden. And you have to interpret that, man. You have to take your own interpretation from it. But I'm telling you what I believe. I believe, like I said, it makes all the sense in the world. They were in the garden and they were told to take something that killed their spiritual, you know, connection to God and the source. So suddenly, boom, they were able to see with their physical eyes. Now it's like, oh my God, I'm naked. How you know I'm naked now? Because I'm looking at you naked. Okay, that opened up the door for distraction. It opened up the door for negative energy and stuff. Okay, why? Because now I can tempt you with the flesh. I can do this. I can use stuff against you. Okay, with the physical stuff that are physically appeased to you or appeals to you. You know what I mean? Stuff that I couldn't do with you on the spiritual level because you didn't look through the physical. When you was spiritual, you saw her through the spiritual. See what I'm saying? So that was the way to connect. So think about it. If you ran into somebody, understand this. If you ran into somebody and you couldn't see them physically, you could not see them with your eyes, you could not smell them with your nose, you could not touch them with your hands or your fingers because you didn't have them, how would you be attracted to that person? How would you be attracted? It wouldn't be a physical attraction because physical attraction wouldn't exist. It ceased to exist. Think about it. On the spiritual realm, physical attraction does not exist. It doesn't. But yet you end up with souls or that are connected, right? I guess there's a couple ways to look at that. Yeah, that's another part I'm gonna have to look into. But like I was saying, guys, you ever see somebody you like? You know, I know I've done it. I've been guilty of it, but I'm learning to see people in a lot of different ways, man. I don't, you know, I see people as people. I see things differently than I may have when I was younger. But I always had a different outlook on people. I always saw the goodness in people. I always saw people, you know, as genuinely good. And always treated people kindly. That's just always been me. And I feel like when your heart and your soul is in alignment, man, you're gonna see the goodness in people and you're gonna see their soul. You're gonna feel the positive energy from them. You're gonna see the positive in them first and foremost, regardless. Before you see their face, before you see any of that, you're gonna feel that, right? But don't get it twisted. You still have to be able to acknowledge when people have bad intentions, when people, you know, even it's people. Let me say, how do I say this? You got people that just because they might be good, nice people, don't mean that they not being used in a bad way and not tempted, you know, by the flesh and stuff, right? They not tempted by the, like, money and fame and power and, you know, other things, you know? That don't mean that they didn't have necessarily have good intentions. It just means that they were easily distracted, whether it's because they vibrate low and they don't have a strong enough spirit, so whereas they can be able to decipher what's right and wrong, what and how to handle certain situations. Who's to say? But everybody's not inclined to be good when you have all these different negative distractions that are constantly falling upon us. Some people gonna be more likely to fall into that hole, you know. But like I said, when you see people right now, we see everybody on a physical, but after some point, think about it. When you go and leave here, say you can't come back. Maybe, like, I could be a soul that has come back, you know, just like Devil Blair said. Who knows what I looked like in the lifetime before? I could have looked totally different. I could have been a white man in the time before. I could have been an Asian man. Who knows? I could have been similar, look almost similar to how I look now. You know, we don't know how that whole piece works, but what we do know is that when you meet people, you judge them, you look at them, you see the physical first. That's everybody, regardless of, you know, what you might think. When you see people, you see the physical appearance, you see the cover of the book. That doesn't necessarily have or have so much of a bearing or influence on what you feel. What you feel as far as maybe the spiritual connection, emotional connection, which emotional and spiritual can be tied together in a sense. Because like I said, we can talk about heart being in alignment with your soul, and to see the soul is in the pineal. Right, so they connected, boom. Your heart might be leading you, but also there could be something that your spirit or your soul is kind of, it could be something where your soul is warranting that connection and your heart is open to it because of the spiritual connection that you might have, if that makes sense. So like a lot of times people talk about, man, they talk about like twin flames and stuff like that. They talk about soulmates and things like that. Those are real things that very well may have just derived from the spiritual connection to somebody. Because soul, spirit, that's what we're talking about. That's that level of attraction. That's that level of connection. On the physical realm, end up with lust and different things like that, okay, and infatuation, you know. You could have a best friend, you have a best friend on the physical realm, but also you could have best souls on the spiritual realm. That makes sense, right? Because like I said, the connections there are going to be different from the connections here, and your reason for those connections are going to differ from your reasons here. Okay, now, let's say in the case you could be here though, don't get it twisted, you could be here on the physical realm and have a strong physical connection with somebody and also have that spiritual connection as well. Now, that's a powerful thing, you know, but it's a level, I think it's a level that you probably don't normally reach with folks, but I believe that's a powerful thing that can really kind of boost a relationship or a connection with somebody, you know, to another level, so to speak. So anyway, guys, I didn't want to make this video too long, man. I wanted to put that out there as far as the connections and things, that since we've been kind of on that, the spiritual piece. And also, like I said, man, if you haven't seen the video before that I put out, what is this? All right, we was talking about the whole firmament piece and all that, and the different dimensions, the levels, the layers. Make sure y'all check that out, man. It's on Rumble. I did put it up on YouTube as well, and I got it rolling on my oldest channel, which is my main channel. I got it rolling on there too, so y'all can check it out just in case. Aside from that, man, make sure y'all get over to the detox shop, man. I can't reiterate this stuff enough. You gotta get your systems cleaned out, man. You gotta get your system cleaned out. Like I tell you all the time, man, people die every day. People die every day. People die all the time. People are sick all the time. And I'm telling y'all, the only reason that people are sick and dying like this is because of the stuff they put in your system. It's that simple, man. They have orchestrated these plans, man. They've been rolling this stuff out. And people that ain't looking into it, people ain't paying attention until all of a sudden they end up sick and dying. That's just how it's set up, man. It's not set up for them to detect when they need to. It's set up for you to need them and to have to go through these, you know, these different processes. So just make sure y'all take care of yourself, man. I know they're going to be doing some damage to people's immune systems over this next couple of months, this winter that we're about to see, man. I always been saying it's going to be a dark winter ever since Biden put that out there. Real talk, we're going to see a lot of dark winters because it's going to be a lot of people whose immune systems is completely devastated. And you're gonna have more deaths, man, and more casualties than we probably ever seen in our history. We are. And it's not gonna be televised. It's not gonna be explained. It's gonna be always rid off as, oh, we got a new variant. But it's really gonna be people dying of the crap they've already done. So anywho, guys, hope y'all enjoyed the video, man. I'll probably put one out probably later this week, probably the weekend, man. I want to tell y'all also that we're probably gonna end up doing a live. I'm gonna do a live in the next 2 weeks because I told y'all I was gonna do one, man. I told y'all about 3-4 months ago last time we did a live, man. But like I said, have everybody come on, man, talk about what you're seeing, what you know, what you heard, you know. Just kind of touch base with everybody and get perspectives from different areas of the country and all to different areas of the world, because we only got eyes on where we at, but it's always some more information that we can pick up on from other places. So anyway, y'all be safe. I'll catch you on the next video.
whispering.